Welcome to an introduction to apportionment. In this lesson, we will define apportionment and state the rules of apportionment. Apportionment is the problem of dividing up a fixed number of things among groups of different sizes. In politics, this takes the form of allocating a limited number of representatives among voters. This problem, presumably, is older than the United States, but the best known ways to solve it have their origins in the problem of assigning each state an appropriate number of representatives in Congress. States also face this apportionment problem in defining how to draw districts for state representatives. The apportionment problem does also come up in a variety of non-political areas. We face several restrictions in this process, which leads us to the apportionment rules. Number one, the things being divided up can exist only in whole numbers, meaning we can't have fraction or decimal parts of the things we are dividing up. Number two, we must use all the things being divided up and we cannot use any more. Three, each group must get at least one of the things being divided up. Four, the number of things assigned to each group should be at least approximately proportional to the population of the group. Exact proportionality isn't possible because of the whole number requirement, but we should try to be close. In any case, if group A is larger than group B, then group B shouldn't get more of the things than group A. In terms of apportionment of the United States House of Representatives, these rules apply. Number one, we can only have whole representatives, meaning a state can't have something like 3.4 representatives. It could only have three or four. Two, we can only use the 435 representatives available. If one state gets another representative, another state has to lose one. Three, every state gets at least one representative. Four, the number of representatives each state gets should be approximately proportional to the state population. This way, the number of constituents each representative has should be approximately equal. So over this next set of lessons, we'll be looking at five ways of solving the apportionment problem. Number one, we'll look at Hamilton's method. Two, Jefferson's method. Three, Webster's method. Four, the Huntington Hill method. And finally, five, the Lowndes method. All but the Lowndes method has been used to apportion U.S. Congress. So I hope you find these upcoming lessons helpful. Thank you for watching.